Okay.
What we're gonna do now is we're going to illustrate a flipping the script in a certain way. Flipping the script. So, what we're gonna do, I will show you. This is a flipping the script, so we're just upside down from what we're used to, right? But it's pretty stable, actually. And if there's any problem, you got your hands here. So we're all starting to go this way, we're all starting to go that way. You can keep yourself stable. And flipping the script, we're looking up now at the sky. You feel a little unstable, but we can stabilize. I didn't use my hand there, but we can tighten the trucks up a little bit. There you go. And you're seeing now from a spaciousness, intrinsic spaciousness, a different perspective. You're flipping the script. So taking a different position than you're used to taking. Like who takes a position like this on a skateboard, right? Who takes the position of flipping the script? There's nothing to escape from. Existence has never happened. I realize, oh, existence has never happened. There's nothing to escape from. I'm seeing this and this and that. You're flipping the script as you sort of have this inner discourse. And then to get back out of this, it's simple. You just go like this, sit up, and then just pivot out the board like that, and you're out of flipping the script, back to wowness like this. And you feel, oh, it's okay. So now I'm back to the regular orientation that I'm used to, I'm familiar with it. But we need to get into that unfamiliar territory, which is lying on our back on the skateboard. We feel, oh, I'm in unfamiliar territory, but I felt quite stable. I didn't feel nervous. It was okay. It was unusual, unfamiliar, but okay. Because we had the stability. We have stability there. We're still using concepts and words. That's the stability, still using concepts and words. Ah. Okay. Anything more to say? Well, stabilize in the wow. Give yourself time to stabilize, I would say. Don't immediately go from flipping the script into running off on your busy existence. Spend some time to let it all sink in, like, hey, I can't do that. I didn't know I could do that. Every time we flip the script, we feel like, I didn't really know I could do that. I'm surprised. I surprised myself. I just surprised myself lying down. Never tried it before, actually. It's the first time I've ever tried that. But I had rehearsed it one time, just before we taped. And it was fine. So I said, wow, I could do this. I could do this. But, whoa. First time. First time's always shaky, right? Your nerves are really like, whoa, what did I just do? Why am I doing this? Whoa. Let all that settle in. Just settle down. Don't struggle with it. Why did I do this? Oh, it's fine. Why did I do that? Oh, it's fine. Why did I do that? Oh, it's fine. It goes like that, right? Oh, that was great. Oh, that was scary. That was great. That was scary. Don't take a position pro or con. No, pro con, no. I'm like, hey, I'm just letting familiarity settle in, and whatever it is, it is. however familiarity wants to treat it, that's, we have no choice but to go along with that. So we honor this issue of familiarity. And when we honor this, guess what? It works for us. It works for us. When we honor our fear like this, of familiar, the familiar continuity fear, and the familiarity issue, when we honor that and say, okay, I'm going to work with you. I'm not going to try to force anything. I'm going to work with you. Then it cooperates. It says, okay, let's do this because I know you're going to give me time to get familiar with it. So I'm okay with trying this. I'm okay with that. But if you try to big time it and force it, say, I don't need to, you know, then familiarity is going to bite you. It's going to come back and sabotage you. You'll sabotage yourself. But when you honor it and go at the pace that it allows you to go at, it doesn't bite you. Your life gets smoothed out. You don't sabotage yourself. So we've gotten to this taping now, which is amazing, actually. Because I'm not forcing anything. I'm just saying, hey, continuity, fair, familiarity, hey, Holy Spirit, what can we do? What can we do now? Without doing too much or too little, what can we do now? Okay, if you take it easy, take it slow, like we're right here in a safe place, no pressure. Guess what? Continuity fair says, go for it. I can handle this. I can handle this. And so, I said, okay, great. Let's do it. Now, you might say, well, this is easy. Well, really? How come no one else is doing it? How come it isn't done often, let's say? Because the continuity fear doesn't allow it. You need the cooperation. The inner cooperation. And you will get it. As psychotic as everyone is. As severely severe psychosis. Everyone here has a severe psychosis, actually. You can work with it. It will actually help you out. It'll say, okay, if you just honor the familiarity issue, okay, let's do this. It really will. I had that dream where I was set free by, I was in this land where everyone was completely psychotic, an entire realm. Sound familiar? Yeah. It's probably this world, right? And the people there had held me captive for a long time, and finally they freed me, they let me go, because they trusted me. Because they realized I was going to work, help them out in the right way. So we keep it simple, we do it direct, simple, and we calm down afterwards like this. Honor the continuity fear, honor familiarity, let us get familiar with this, and your path will go smoothly for you, and you'll be successful. Thank you.